We're joined on Morning Bull and 97 Rock, Bull, Rob, Bobby, Chris, by MK. He is a 17-year professional butler and butlering at the appropriately Butler House down in Cherry Creek. He joins us this morning. MK, good morning. Thanks for joining the program. How are you?
Good morning. I'm good. That's my pleasure.
So
thank you so much.
You're very welcome. So we want to know a little bit about butlering. Is that a proper term?
Yes, butler, yes. Yeah, it's a proper butlering, yes.
So what is your 17-year career being a butler? Like, how did you start out being a butler? What does that entail?
I graduated hospitality management from the British Institute for Hospitality Management. After this, I started working in hospitality in five-star hotels. I got to learn about the butler service while I was working at the Four Seasons hotels. And this was for me something new. I didn't know about it. I felt that this is my career. I felt I want to go this way. I started to study. I got the training. And then also I moved to different hotels. I worked with Fairmont Hotels. And I was trained by the Victorian butler, someone who did work with the Queen, Clarence McLeod, at this time. And he was my first trainer. And then from this time, I become a professional butler. Moving forward with hotels, I was the first butler in W Hotels. Then I had the opportunity to open my own place, which is the Cherry Creek Inn, which was up for sale. I did buy the place, and we are offering now a butler service as well as a school. So we are the first butler school in the area, if not in New York.
Someone could register for you to learn how to be a butler.
Exactly, yes. So through the American Butler School, aside from the Butler House at the Cherry Creek Inn, we have also the school in the property.
So if I were to go to the Butler Inn in Cherry Creek and say, I want to opt for butler service, what is that going to cost me and what do I get?
So, just to manage expectations, because sometimes also people, when they book the stay with us, they think that they will have all the time white gloves and black suit, but we do offer services to guests when they come and stay with us, just a casual service, a casual stay, which you just meet at the door and check in, and personalizing the service is something else, which if I am staying at the property and I ask for a butler, then you are getting personalized service, a perfect shoe shine. This is what we do for you, cleaning your suit and your dress. In-room dining, so in the morning you don't have to come down for breakfast. We bring the breakfast to you.
MK is a 17-year trained, classically trained, Victorian trained butler.
Seems like a lot of work to be a butler, and it seems like you're always on call. So does that type of job pay well?
It does. I mean, I have to say, the salaries that, like, we do recruitment as well. So if you study with us, we help you to find the right job. So, for example, I'm looking for someone now to work in a private household in LA, in Beverly Hills, and the salary is from 100 to 150K. Of course, the salary is very good, but also you do a lot of jobs. We get people work, like I know one of the butlers who work with a royal family that they usually come to New York City. His salary is $500,000 a year.
Wow.
So oh my gosh.
He's actually managing for them everything around the residence at the Plaza Hotel in New York. So his salary is, but when you see a salary like this, you think, oh, it's huge, but they really do a hard job behind that.
Very interesting. MK, I have another question from your personal experience. So you mentioned working at places like the Four Seasons and very high-end hotels.
Yes.
Do you remember the biggest tip you ever got?
I got a tip from a great person. Actually, he is the reason why I'm in the United States now. So the same person, he gave me a full set of diamond. So full set of diamond. I didn't know that this is diamond. I just kept it in my closet for like 2 or 3 months. Once I just felt like I really didn't need it and I was thinking to sell it, I found out it's diamond. So it's necklace, earrings, and rings. Full set of diamonds. This was a tip that I got from one of my guests working in a hotel.
What did it add up to when you cashed it in?
They said This is actually, I sold it very cheap, but actually it's about $45,000.
Wow!
Yeah. So, but
good luck, good luck in Cherry Creek.
Yeah, so,
I'm familiar with Cherry Creek. Here's a coat rack made out of an elk's head.
You will get the opportunity. Like, I will give you an example. This has happened at the Plaza Hotel in New York. Not just that you have this all the time, but most of the butlers, we do something called personalized service. The butler is someone who personalizes the service for you, who makes it specifically goes around your needs. This is the difference between the butler and anyone else within the hotel. So we have this butler who knows the guest who's coming from the Middle East, and he comes every year. He's from the royal family in one of the countries in the Middle East, and he knows that he's coming every single year. So he was waiting for him this year with something special. He went to one of his colleagues that he speaks Arabic, and he asked him to translate to him, to teach him how to say the word, welcome back to our hotel in Arabic. And he started to study this before the guests come, and then when he's going and greeting the guests, he welcomed him in his own language. So what happened at this moment, he makes the prince smile, he makes him happy, and the prince tipped him at $10,000.
Oh, man.
On the spot. And that was something that happened. That happened like 3 years ago or 4 years ago, I believe, at the Plaza, and this everyone was talking about. So you see, this little thing creates a big difference.
Yeah, but you're in Cherry Creek. What are you putting out? Like the Chautauqua County Penny Saver and the leftover wings from Whiskey Hill?
When the guests come here, this is what I learned about the guests when they arrive to the place. So I believe the guests, when they come and give me a chance for like one or two nights, some of the guests, I got the chance to talk to them before they come. So I understand what is the reason for their stay, why they are coming here, and then I personalize the service around their needs.
Hey, Rob, so I'm going to go to Rabbi Alex, and I'm going to learn a Hebrew greeting for you tomorrow, and that's
fair enough.
Find out what you tip me.
Yeah, guess what? Hey, MK, this was super interesting. I have a feeling you may have three or four new students in your school.
How can people find you? What do you have, a website? You got a phone number? Both?
We have our website, theamericanbutlerschool.com, and we have the butler.house. So our website is very easy, butler.house. And the other website is theamericanbutlerschool.com.
Fantastic.
Super interesting. Yeah. Well, thank you for your time, yeah. MK.
Thank you for inviting me to the show.
And we're gonna look to book a place down there, and if not, apply to your school.
Thank you so much, and it will be my pleasure to welcome you to our place.
MK, thank you so much for doing this in Buffalo with us at 97
Take care
Rock.
Of yourself.
All right, it's 8:55 on Morty Bold. We'll podcast that for you at 97rock.com. Yes, there's an actual butler here in Western New York. Runs his own butler school, and it's the Butler House at the Cherry Creek Inn. We've actually looked at it. It's super nice. It's an old Victorian. And if you want to get out of the concrete jungle or want to suggest to somebody that lives in one and just basically go out and enjoy some country life and have everything pretty much done for you and personalized, definitely check it out for sure. Podcast available, 97rock.com with the 97 Rock app, iTunes, Google, Spotify, and Stitcher as well. MK, thanks for doing that with us. It was a lot of fun. And eye-opening to us to find out that there were actually at least one butler here in Western New York. Okay, Rob said, coming up in a second. Let's get to the weather. Final look at it today. It's been an odd, but normal in a way, Western New York weather pattern. You know that weather's not always the same everywhere in Western New York, and that is absolutely the case right now, as it's been sunny over our head at James E. Casey most
the
of the morning.
And
again, we know there have been showers
in
some of the suburbs here and throughout a lot of the southwest in Western New York. Showers for a lot of the day today.
That was okay for a first-time interview in the radio. It was okay, right?
82 for a high.
Yeah, it was okay.
With sun and clouds. And then let's get
it was fine.
Labor Day holiday weekend.
I like it.
Cool on Friday and Saturday. 72 both days, so kind of
from now on I'm listening
feeling
to
with
this
sunshine
channel,
both
so.
Those days, and then Sunday and Monday even better.
Thank you.
Sunshine 75 to 80 with highs both of those days. So if you're doing a little Labor Day staycation, weather will work out for you. It's 8:57.